ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 17th பாசுரம். அம்பரமே தண்ணீரே சோரே அறம் செய்யும் எம்பெருமான் நந்த கோபாலா எழுந்திராய். கொம்பனார்க்கெல்லாம் கொழுந்தே குலவிளக்கே எம்பெருமாட்டி யசோதாய் அறிவுராய். அம்பரு மூடரு தோங்கி உலகளந்த உம்பர் கோமானே உறங்காதெழுந்திராய். செம்பொற்கழலடி செல்வா பலதேவா உம்மியும் நீயும் உறங்கேலோரெம்பாவாய். இன் த ஃபோர்த் சீன் ஆஃப் த திருப்பாவை, ஆண்டாள் ஹாஸ் ரீச்ட் த பேலஸ் ஆஃப் லார்ட் கிருஷ்ணா அண்ட் சீக்கிங் பர்மிஷன் ஃப்ரம் த கேட் கீப்பர் அண்ட் த டோர் கீப்பர் ஷி ஹாஸ் நவ் என்டர்ட் இன்சைட். ஆஸ் ஷி என்டர்ஸ் இன்சைட் ஷி ஃபைண்ட்ஸ் தி என்டையர் ஹவுஸ்ஹோல்ட் ஆஃப் கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்லீப்பிங். ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஃபீல் தட் தே ஷுட் அப்ரோச் கிருஷ்ணா இன் அ வெரி ரைட்டியஸ் வே. ஸோ தே வாண்ட் டு சீக் பர்மிஷன் ஆஃப் ஆல் எல்டர்ஸ் பிஃபோர் கோயிங் அண்ட் அப்ரோச்சிங் கிருஷ்ணா. ஸோ தி எல்டர்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஹவுஸ் ஆர் தி பேரண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் கிருஷ்ணா. ஸோ ஆண்டாள் ஃபைண்ட்ஸ் தட் நந்தகோபா அண்ட் யசோதா த பேரண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் கிருஷ்ணா ஆர் ஆல்சோ அஸ்லீப் அண்ட் ஸோ ஷி ப்ரொசீட்ஸ் டு வேக் தெம் அப் ஃபர்ஸ்ட். ஸோ இன் திஸ் 17th பாசுரம் ஆண்டாள் பிகின்ஸ் வித் வேக்கிங் அப் ஆஃப் நந்தகோபா. நவ் இட் இஸ் சேட் இன் த சாஸ்திராஸ் தட் வென் யூ ட்ரை டு வேக் சம்படி அப் யூ ஷுட் ப்ரேஸ் தெம் அண்ட் வேக் தெம் அப். திஸ் இஸ் த பெஸ்ட் வே ஆஃப் வேக்கிங் ஒன் அப் and it also has some practical implication. If we are waking up somebody on some purpose of ours, it would obviously be better to keep him on a good note and wake him up, praise him, give him some good feeling so that he will do what we want. So Andal is well aware of both the shastric lore and this practical implication. So very nicely she praises Nandagopa and wakes him up. How is Nandagopa? Andal says, Ambarame tannire sore aram seyyum emberuman Nandagopala. She calls out as emberuman Nandagopala, O Lord Nandagopala. She calls Nandagopa as the Lord because he is the father of the Lord of the universe. So definitely he is somebody who must be bowed down to. So he is that respectable. So Andal calls him as Lord Nandagopala, Emberuman Nandagopala. And this Nandagopa is known for his charity, it seems. Aram seyyum Emberuman Nandagopala, she says. Aram seyyum denotes the one who does a lot of charity. And Nandagopa was very generous with his charity, it seems. He would generously give away clothes, ambharamE. He would generously give people food and water. Sore tannire sore aram seyyum. He would very willingly feed any number of people who came to his house at any point of time and would also unhesitantly give clothes to people in abundance. Now these girls have come to Nandagopala and they are praising his charity for what actually? It is because according to these girls, everything is Krishna. Alvar describes that for him, Unnum soru, parugum neer, tinnum vetrilayum, yellam kannan. For him, food, water and any bhoga vastu or anything that he enjoyed was all Lord Krishna. So also for these girls, everything is Lord Krishna. Clothing, food, water, anything of enjoyment was all Krishna for them. So, Nandagopa, who was so generous in giving charity of these things, now was expected to generously give Krishna to them, who was everything to them. Krishna was their ambaram. Krishna was their tannir. Krishna was their sor. So, they are asking Nandagopala to give this Krishna who is there, ambharamE, tannire, sore, to them. So they are generously asking Nandagopala to part with Krishna for their sake or allow him to become their friend. So Nandagopa is very happy hearing the smart pun of these girls. He understood the wisdom behind their words, and very smilingly he lets them in. Next, the girls proceed to wake up Yashoda Devi, the mother of Krishna. And it is said again in the Shastras that one must not go and wake up her mother-in-law. It is said in the Shastras so. We must not go and wake up our mother-in-law. That is not correct. Andal is well aware of that. So when she reaches Yashoda's bed, she doesn't say Yelindirai, that is get up. She only says Arivurai. Oh Yashoda Devi, oh mother Yashoda, please know that we have come. For your information, we are saying that we are here. You need not get up and strain yourself for our sake. And when she is thus calling out to Yashoda Devi, she gives some adjectives to Yashoda Devi too. How is Yashoda Devi? Kumbanar kellam kolunde kulavilakke. Yashoda Devi is like the kulavilakku, the ancestral lamp of Gokulam. She is the auspicious light of Gokulam. And she is also kolundu. Kolundu means a young leaf, a little leaflet which has just been born. Whenever a plant gets affected with some disease, the first part to be affected is this young leaflet. It seems Yashoda was also like this. If any of the Gopas or Gopikas had any problem, she was the first one to feel bad about it. So much compassion she had. And only because of this, the Lord, who is the most compassionate one, chose her as his mother. So Andal highlights on this characteristic of Yashoda, of being the most compassionate one. So she says, Kolinde, Kolinde Kulavilakke. She is the Kolindu, she is the Kulavilakku of Kombanar Kellam. Kombanar refers to all the Gopas and Gopikas. So she is this beautiful, auspicious lamp and young leaf of Gokulam. And she is also our goddess, Emperumati, she says. If Nandagopala was the Lord, Emperuman, then obviously Yashoda Devi becomes goddess or Emperumati. So, giving Yashoda Devi this status of being like goddess Lakshmi, Andal proceeds inside. Indeed, Yashoda Devi was like that. She was so compassionate. So, Yashoda Devi also hears these girls say all these beautiful things. And she is very happy that her son's friends are so well versed in the Shastras that they know that their future mother-in-law shouldn't be woken up. All these girls have an intention to marry Krishna. And so Yashoda would become their future mother-in-law, and they are taking care not to wake her up but to just inform her and go. So they are giving due regard and respect and still following the Shastra of not waking her up. Now here we may get a question as to, so many girls are going to marry Krishna, is it? The answer is yes. Because the Vedas say that the Lord is the only Purusha or the only male and all others are females. The understanding that we need to get behind this is that the Lord is the one to whom we all need to go and surrender and serve. So, he is considered as the Purusha. And we are all Stri Prayas. So, by nature, we go and surrender to him, seek him, and he gives us asylum. So, that is the relationship of this Bhavam of Stri and Purusha here. And so, these girls want to marry the Lord for this purpose, for attaining him and serving him. And thus, in this aspect, Yashoda would become their mother-in-law if they marry the Lord. And so the girls are very well following the respect that is to be given to their mother-in-law even before they get wedded to the Lord. And the mother-in-law is happy and lets them in. And these girls go ahead to wake up Krishna now. They say, Ambar mudarithu ongi ulagalanda umbar komane uranga delindirai. They call out to the Lord, Umbar komane, the Lord of Lords, get up. Uranga delindirai. You should not be sleeping, get up. Why is this Lord Umbar Koman or the Lord of Lords? Because once upon a time, he tore open the skies and measured the worlds. Ambaru mood aruthu. He tore open the skies and Ongi Ulagalanda lifted his foot to a great height and measured the worlds. This measurement of the world happened during the Trivikrama Avatara when Mahabali told him that he would give him 3 measures of earth that he had asked as Vamana. Vamana came to Mahabali and asked for 3 footsteps of sand. And Vamana was a very short brahmachari when he asked for this charity. As soon as Mahabali agreed to give charity, Vamana grew in stature and became Trivikrama. He became so big that he actually tore open the skies. And with 1 footstep of his, he measured this world. And with the other, he measured the sky. And then everything was already measured. So he asked Mahabali, where do I place my 3rd foot? And Mahabali said, you can keep the foot on my head. And thus Mahabali was humbled and also blessed by the Lord. And not only Mahabali, but the entire world was blessed by the Lord because of association of his divine feet. Now we saw that a mention of Ongi Ulagalanda was also done in the 3rd Pasuram. And I spoke about the same Trivikramavatara there. And there we saw that the reason that she spoke about Trivikrama Avatara was to ward off any evil that could come at the time of this Margari Vrata. Whenever we are doing any yaga or anything, any prayer for the Lord, then we may have obstacles. And it is said that when we think of this Trivikrama Avatara of the Lord, these obstacles fly away. The same reason holds true here also. Andal spoke about the Trivikrama Avatara when she was explaining about the Nombu to her friends in the 1st scene. And now they are beginning with the Nombu in the 4th scene. So, at this time, again she is remembering this Trivikrama. And not only that, becoming Trivikrama, the Lord proved that he is above all. He is the Lord of Lords and he is thus the attainable. He is the one who can grant us refuge, the only one. And so, he is the greatest. Umbar Koman means the Lord of Lords, the greatest. So thus, O Lord, you being the greatest are our only refuge. And so we have come to you. Please wake up. Uranga Derindirai, they say. The Lord is not yielding to them. He is not even listening apparently. Or he is not responding. Something is happening but Krishna is not getting up. So these girls are wondering why. Then they remember, oh, we have forgotten somebody very important. Another elder is there in the household, the elder brother of Krishna, that is Balarama, and we have not woken him up. Come on, let us go and wake him up first. So, these girls proceed to Balarama and try to wake him up. Sempor kalaladi chelva baladeva umbiyum niyum urange lorembavai. They call out to Balarama as Baladeva and tell him that you and your brother must not be sleeping. Umbiyum niyum urangel, they say. Now this Balarama is called as Selva Baladeva, that is the lucky Balarama. Why? Because it seems his feet are very lucky. Sempur Kalaladi, meaning the one having lucky golden feet. Why was the feet of Balarama considered lucky? There's a story behind this. We all know that Kamsa had jailed Devaki Devi and Vasudeva because he was under the threat that the 8th child of Devaki would slay him. He had got some intimation from the divine sources that he would be slain by the 8th child of Devaki and he wanted to somehow get rid of this danger. So he had jailed Devaki and Vasudeva. Now as Devaki's children were born, Kamsa initially thought that he had threat only from the 8th child. But then he was led to the confusion that you never know what is told by divine interventions. Many a times the devas or divine commands that come from the devas are a little confusing. You have got some instruction that the 8th child of Devaki would kill you. But what if the 1st child of Devaki kills you and the divine command which told you would explain to you that actually I had said count from the eighth child. If Devaki has eight children and if you count from the eighth one, then the first one becomes the eighth. So that was going to slay you. That is what I had warned. The Devas would tell Kamsa, it seems. So this kind of confusion was created in Kamsa's mind, and then he decided to kill all of Devaki's children as soon as they were born. So as Devaki started giving birth to children, Kamsa started killing them. And he would come and very atrociously kill them the moment they were born. Like that, Devaki lost 6 children in a row. Then when she conceived for the 7th time, she was very worried for her child too. Some divine power suddenly took this fetus from Devaki Devi's womb and transplanted it to Rohini Devi's womb. Rohini Devi was another wife of Vasudeva. And she was at that time in Gokulam under the refuge of Nandagopa. Vasudeva had told her to go and stay in Gokulam in his friend's house so that she would be safe. And she was staying there. And suddenly she realized that her womb got filled with a fetus. And this was nothing but the one which was transplanted from Devaki. So Balarama, this fetus later on became Balarama. And this Balarama is known to be as Sankarshana, the transferred one, the transplanted one, right in the womb. So that way Balarama, the 7th child, got saved. Now, after Balarama entered the womb of Devaki Devi, Lord Krishna was born to Devaki Devi and he survived. And after that, she had another daughter too, named Subhadra. So, after Balarama set foot into the womb of Devaki Devi, she could retain her children. She had lost 6 children before. But after Balarama's lucky foot got set into the womb of Devaki Devi, she could retain all her children. So Balarama is called as Lucky Balarama. And the one having lucky feet, Sempur Kalaladi Chelva Baladeva Umbiyum Niyum Urange Lorembavai. You must not be sleeping, O Balarama, they say. And we all know that you are an incarnation of Adisesha. Adisesha is the bed of the Lord. Have you ever heard of a bed sleeping? People sleep on a bed. But does a bed sleep by itself? So you being Adisesha should not be sleeping. But please wake up and make your brother also to wake up. So saying thus, these girls wake up Balarama, and Balarama also smilingly allows them to proceed to wake up Krishna. Let us see what the girls do tomorrow in the next Pasuram.